James the Jaw Thomas. I'll be playing Sergeant Toomey in the scene with the wallet and Biloxi Blues.
And I'm Robert McLeish, and I'll be playing Arnold Epstein in the scene Biloxi Blues.
What do you guys do with Housky? Please, I'm blocking air.
I'm Danny.
Yeah, I'm going to do with Housky.
It
just has one line.
I'm Sergeant Jay.
Six. Seven. Eight, nine.
There's $62 if anyone cares to count it.
I don't think that'll be necessary, but I would Kowski, pick up your money. I said don't count it, boy. Private Epstein, do you have anything to say?
No, Sergeant.
May I ask you why you returned the money?
I chose to.
You chose to? Knowing full well that swift and just punishment may be inflicted upon you when if this is reported to the commanding officer.
I know it only too well.
You could have kept quiet about this incident. Chances are no one would have found out or been the wiser.
I didn't see any reason why five innocent men should suffer loss of privilege because of one guilty one.
Private Wilkowski, is it your wish that I report this incident and the guilty party to the commanding officer?
I just want my money, Sergeant. I can deal with the bastard who took it on my own.
Last night at 0100 hours, I wandered through these barracks and saw carelessness and complacency. Wilkowski's wallet was lying in an open footlocker, inviting weakness, avarice, and temptation. I took your money, Wilkowski. Returned the empty wallet in its place. I did to teach you a lesson. Instead, I got submarined. Epstein, are you such a goddamn ignorant fool to take the blame for something you were completely innocent of?
The Army has its logic. I have my own.
The Army's logic, as you call it, is to instill discipline, obedience, and unquestioned faith in superiors. What the hell is yours?
Since I'm not guilty of a crime, I reserve the privilege to keep my own motives, a matter of confidentiality.
That's where you're wrong, soldier. Confessing to a crime you didn't commit is no less an offense than confessing to one you did commit. That is called obstruction of justice. You may not like our rules, boy. But by God, you will clean every toilet and every piss pot until you learn them. Confine the barracks until further notice. The rest of you are on a 48 hours leave. Fall out! Epstein, I would like a word with you in private. Listen to me, you fly speck on and out of horseshit. You're taking me on, ain't you? Well, you're making a big mistake. Because I have a nutcracker that crunches the testicles of the men who take me on. How the hell do you think you can beat me?
I'm not trying to beat you, Sergeant. I'm trying to work with you.
Work with me? I think you're low on batteries, Epstein. I think some plumber turned off your fountain of knowledge. The hell do you mean, working with me?
I don't think it's necessary to dehumanize a man to get him to perform. You can get better results by raising our spirits than lowering our dignity.
Why in the hell did you put the money back that you know you didn't take?
Because I knew you did. I saw you take it. I think inventing a crime that didn't exist to enforce your theories of discipline is Neanderthal in its conception.
I can arrange it, Epstein. But from now on, you get nothing to eat in the mess hall except cotton balls. You ever eat cotton balls, Epstein? You can chew it till 1986. They don't swallow. Men do not face enemy machine guns because they have been treated with kindness. They face them because they have a bayonet up their ass. I don't want them human. I want them obedient.
The Egyptian kings made their slaves obedient. Eventually, they lost their slaves and their kingdom.
Yeah, well, I may lose mine, but before you go, you're going to build me the biggest goddamn pyramid you ever saw. I'm trying to save these boys' lives, you crawling bookworm. Stand in my way. I'll pulverize you into chicken droppings.
Should be an interesting contest, Sergeant.
After I crush your testicles, you can replace them with the cotton balls. Neanderthal conception. Jesus Christ.
And see?